Welcome to another IT Friday.
Welcome.
This is Tom. I'm Steven. And today we're talking about connect, talk, think and act. Because last IT Friday we talked about IT platforms. And we mentioned CTTA, the CTTA model. And today we're going to explain what it is.
Yeah, you're correct.
Why is it important?
It's important because we need CTTA in order to create a simple definition of the Internet of Things. If we want to explain to you what the Internet of Things is all about, we can come up with a lot of stories about examples of products in the field, in factories,
technologies,
in our daily lives, technologies. But it's better to have a simple, clean definition. And I think Connect, Talk, Think, and Act can really help in make that definition, actually. So it's good to start with the first layer, the Connect layer, and explain to you what all these layers are about. And as I said, let's start with Connect.
Yeah, okay. So Connect is not really about the connection, but it's about what you're connecting. And that is sensors, it's measuring the environment, the world, basically. And that can be an object, an existing object, such as a plant, or a car, or an existing product that you already have.
Basically. A thing, right?
A thing, basically, uh-huh, yes, indeed.
Uh-huh. The thing of Internet of Things.
That's why it's called the Internet of Things, indeed. So it's about connecting the thing and measuring it and putting these measurements into an analog or a digital format, mm-hmm, that can be transmitted. And they used to do something with this data.
Okay, so transmitting, then we're going towards the second layer.
That
already is
indeed the second layer. So that's the talk layer, and that is really about connectivity.
Mm-hmm.
Having your connected thing talk to a cloud environment or a gateway or a phone even.
Now we're bringing in technology, right? Because
so yes, that is the technology layer, and it is you need technology to be able to do it.
Mm-hmm.
But the layer is important, so you don't have to talk about technology itself.
Okay, so talking can be very locally, RFID-like, but also
yes,
globally, mobile, 4G connections and stuff like that. And then we enter into the think layer, of course, because now we're collecting the data.
Yeah.
And with collecting data, we can do something with it. And it's not only about collecting data from the field. So it's not only about collecting temperatures and measurements of movement, GPS coordinates and stuff like that. It's also about combining it with existing data, historical data maybe even.
Process
data could be, yeah.
How your process works.
Yeah. If you look at factories, for example, it's very, very handy to have process data, historical data in there. Combine it with dynamically collected data from the now perspective,
yeah,
from your factory. Combine it together, do something smart with it, and make a conclusion, draw a conclusion out of this big set of data that you end up with.
So that can also be big data storages,
sure,
combining all this data, historic data, and then getting a conclusion. And,
yeah,
and what are you doing with this conclusion?
Yeah, conclusion.
Because I think that's,
that's
the most important part of any IT solution.
Yeah, it's about bringing business value to a customer eventually. And this conclusion helps you to eventually act on something. And that's the fourth layer that we're entering now. The act layer is where the activity takes place. And it can be something physical, like you and me acting upon a signal that we get from our mobile phones even. But it can also be
replace my battery.
Sure, sure. Yeah, and go forth. But it could also be something that houses in the thing, where we started the four layers with, where the sensors are. It can also have an actor that does something. It can open a gate for you. It can send
any physical response or even a digital response, such as
anything,
a light or a display.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, and that makes the four layers. We also covered now the description of every layer, what it's about, and that can help you define your IoT definition or the definition of your
in
IT solution.
In a non-technical way.
In a non-technical way, and now we've taken it apart, but it also helps definitely to bring in the technology for each of those layers. And that's
okay,
also handy if you are talking about making an IT solution from existing products, for
yep,
example. You might have a couple of those layers or parts of those layers from a technical perspective in place, and you want to add two or three or maybe even one layer only to make it a full IT solution.
Okay, and this then helps to say in which of those layers this is and what kind of technologies are available within this layer.
And make a choice then on what is needed, implement it, and the IT solution takes shape, basically.
Okay, great. So if you have any questions on the CTTA model or any feedback, we love to hear it.
Yeah.
We use it a lot to talk also with the business on a non-technical way about it, and then place it into technology eventually. We hope to see you next time on IT Friday. It was fun. Have a good weekend for now.
Yeah, share some new topics where you want to have us talk about, and see you next time on IT Friday.
Bye-bye.
Bye.